it doesn't matter whose idea it was. What matters is that the unthinkable is now inevitable. I'm going to give you my modest proposal for this sequester, which is we should take the relevant members of Congress and the administration, put them on that stinky cruise ship, and send them back out there. But I want to say that the notion that there is government waste, there is more waste to cut. The absolute worst way to cut it is in the across-the-board, unthinking mechanism of the sequester. And second, the impact of the sequester is bigger than it would appear if you just take it as a percentage of the budget as a whole.
Because they're not touching entitlements.
It doesn't touch most entitlements. So it hits two things very hard. It hits domestic spending, which has already shrunken as the size of the economy to the levels of the Eisenhower administration, and it hits defense spending effectively because you're cramming it all into 7 months, 9% of domestic spending, 13% cut in defense spending. That's not smart government.
And Stuart, that's a big hit in the Pentagon. I mean, we all know there's some waste over there, but that's a big hit immediately.
Yeah, but Jonathan, you opened the show correctly with the most powerful person in the world saying it wasn't going to happen. I can't believe, given his extraordinary communication powers, that he can't get people together, talk to the country, and solve this problem. It doesn't look like he's really trying very hard. I mean, it's just not the top item on his agenda. And he's made that clear.
So you're endorsing the cruise ship idea.
I like the cruise ship idea, particularly if it can maybe come close to being hit by a meteorite, because then it would be...
we can bring it all together.
It would be just a huge cable bonanza. But this is just, it's a test of leadership. I mean, this is why we have in our system a president. He's a leader. He's got to lead us through this crisis. And it's just not happening.